Drawing a spline is a great way for us to take something with lots of arcs, lots of curves, and we can start to create a more consistent, more rolling look rather than trying to use arcs. Arcs sometimes make it tough because as we start to combine arcs, it's not going to allow some points to start to move or roll. So in this case, I went through and shot with capture across, and I started to shoot crosses all over my pool area here. So I'm going to go to draw a spline. And I'm going to make sure my snapping is on. And I'm going to start, we'll say right here. So I'm going to start here and start clicking. As I start clicking, you're going to notice how my points start to transition with it. Now, you're going to notice that this one here has quite a bit of a wiggle to it. Now, when we go in here to shoot these, there are going to be times where we shoot a lot more points, maybe a few less points, depending on what we're doing. But these aren't straight lines. So we're capturing exactly what's there. But what we're going to do is go through and start clicking on all of our points. Now, if I get to somewhere where I'm starting to notice that I don't necessarily like how it totally looks, I don't like this, I can just go back and skip that point. Now, when I skip that point, I want to make sure that I am still coming close to it. So as you can see, I can start to check and see how close am I to that point. Now, if we're going to add overhang, these might be some of those extra options that we have that we can add our overhang. It may be a little shorter there, but as long as we're covering in some scenarios, we're kind of still in that safe nature. But I can keep clicking as many or as little as I want. And you're going to notice how it starts to create more gentle, consistent flows. And when I get down to here, I'm going to click on this one, but I'm going to skip that one. We'll see what happens. So I'm going to keep clicking. And as you notice, it's actually running it pretty close to it. So it all comes down to what point you want to take. And I could have taken more. I could have taken less. If I took more points, I probably would have just clicked on a few less points. But as you can see, it's a great way for us to kind of start taking all of our points and creating a more consistent spline, in this case, that we can then send to the saw to be able to cut. Now, I'm going to skip a few points and start getting towards the end here. When we get near the end, we're going to click on our last point, and instead of clicking onto here, we're going to actually come up here and hit the close button. What it does is it actually blends that point together for us, and when I hit done, we're left with just our spline. It's a very easy way to start to create more consistent arcs that we can have something to start with, and then we can have something that's a little bit more fluid to what we're trying to cut. Now we're going to talk about editing the spline. So down in this section here, you can see we obviously have a lot of little waves, we're going to call them. And I want to start to blend some of these points out. When we're dealing with big parts like this, sometimes obviously you're dealing with concrete, you might be dealing with different substrates. And we need to take these and pull these points out. We want to make a little bit more consistent flow. If I go back into draw spline, all I have to do is click on the spline, and the spline now becomes editable. What I have the ability to do is to grab my points and start pulling them where I want them to go. Now, by doing this, you can see I can also shift things. So I'm trying to get a more consistent flow by adding more overhang in certain areas. So as we continue through, we're just going to keep kind of shifting and playing a little bit, and it's going to create that more consistent look that we're obviously trying to get. Now, I like how this looks, but let's say this point. I'm going to pull this point up just a little bit like that. Obviously, I'm adding a little more overhang, which is perfectly fine in most cases there. But we're going to keep going all the way around, start playing with how it looks. Now, I see one more I want to kind of fix just a little bit right there. We're going to pull this one just a tiny bit out. Now, you can do this while you're in the field. You can do this when you get back to the shop. But in this case here, this is kind of showing you, you can see where we shot our points. So I'm going to take this one, and I'm going to take it and kind of bring this point a little closer over to here and shift it up. Probably a part where I should have shot more points. So I could have seen where I was kind of overlaying a little bit more. But as we kind of start to get it closer, I'm going to hit the done button. And now you can start to see how we're getting a little bit more of a gentle flow. So we do have the option to edit them. Now, if I don't like what I see, all I need to do is go back into spline, click on the spline again. Now those points all become editable again. So now I can start grabbing my points, and maybe I don't like how this one looks, so we're going to pull that one back a little bit more and hit done. But we have the option to edit these splines to try to get them as far in or out or as consistent as we want to. I hope this helps.